Today I will show you how to draw this cute illustration in textured style. I will sketch the hare from scratch, but if you like, you can download the sketch file along with the brushes and color palette I created for this tutorial. If you like these YouTube videos, you may want to check out my Patreon, where you can unlock even more tutorials, brush packs, and support me at the same time. Without any further delay, let's begin drawing! This time I will be working on a square canvas that is 2000 by 2000 pixels. I suggest we first create the main shapes for our illustration and later we apply textures. So now I'll go to the color palette and select this blue that comes first. In the brushes, I will pick monoline from calligraphy set. The brush size can be 6 or 7%. And we need to draw a circle. That is big enough. I will wait a second, then tap on the canvas to make a perfect shape. Now we can fill it by dragging the color inside. I will also move it a bit to the left, so it is placed in the middle. Now let's create one more layer above the circle and change the color into green. That comes next. I'm going to the brush set that you will find in the description to this video. And here you can see my favorite textures and a couple of new brushes that are acrylic mixed brush and mixed paper brush. That is one of the papers that I also shared at my Patreon recently. The set includes 20 brushes and 30 PNG images. Some of them are transparent and others are colored. You can check this set out if you want. For now, I will select acrylic mixed brush. And we will draw this part of the grass on the lower part of the circle. I will make the brush size low enough, like 9 or 8%. And I will first draw a curvy line here on the lower part of the circle. It will go a little outside on this edge, and at the bottom it will consist of a few curvy shapes. First I will draw it this way, then I will make a bigger curve, and then a smaller one. Now let's paint inside it. I will increase the brush size a little to 13% to paint in the middle. Here I will repeat the outlines. All right. Here as well. And we are getting this wet edge. That's why I used this brush. Later, when we apply texture on this shape, it will look even better. On the smaller shape, I will lower the brush size to 8%. I will also clean this tip using eraser set to same brush, but with a low brush size, around 4 or 3%. I'll just make it sharp. Let's have a look. If your shape got a bit too transparent, you can always go and duplicate it, so the color will be opaque. Then I will merge these two layers. Now I can see that we need to remove this part of the circle. I'll be using eraser here. That can actually be set to soft brush. That's it. Now I will create a layer between these two to draw the tree. I will also first draw some basic shapes, and then we will see what else we can add on it. In the palette, I will select the darkest green color from this row. And I'll be using same acrylic mixed brush. Let's make the size 12% and draw an oval shape somewhere here. I will paint inside it, making these circular strokes. Alright. Now let's create a layer above it and change the color into this one that we used for the grass. Now I will draw on the sides of this shape, this way. And it will also go to the left. Here I will make the brush size a bit smaller, like 8%. Let's create one last layer for the foliage above this one. And I will pick a lighter shade of green next to it. Here I will draw a shape of a bean. Here I will draw like this. And on top it will be like an arc. Let's paint inside it with a bigger brush size, so it just goes faster. And now I will fix these shapes. I will make this line more smooth. And I think I will fix this layer a bit. I'll erase it. But then pick this dark green with my finger, go back to this layer and paint in this gap. Here I will make it look more like a circle. And here too. Well, that's fine. Let me pick the lightest green. I will go to the layer with this bean shape. Make the brush size 23% and add these light strokes. In the middle of the shape. Now I will pick this base green. Go to this layer, that is layer number 4. And I will add another shape on the side. Something like this. I will continue working on this layer, but I will change the color into a lighter one and draw an oval shape here. What I want is to create a tree shape that will look creative. Finally, I will switch to the lightest green. Make the size 13% and draw here. Add in this highlight. We only need to draw the tree trunk. For that, I will pick this reddish color. I will create a layer between these two. We can actually make the size a bit smaller. And I will draw an arc. It will be wider at the bottom. Let's draw a couple of branches going to the left. So I'm making the brush size 2% and drawing like this. Then a smaller one, going more to the right. I'm making the strokes lifting my pencil every time. All right, let's draw a tree branch going to the left from here. I will start this way, and then it will be split. Like one branch will go to the right from here and another one go to the left. I will also make a branch going to the left here. Fine. Maybe a small one here. And another one. When the trunk is ready, I will add shading on it. We can either alpha lock this layer or create a new one above it with a clipping mask. More often I prefer the second option, so I will go for it. Creating a new layer and clipping it. Let's pick a darker color that comes next after this red. I will lower the brush opacity to 95%, so I have more control over the pressure. We can make the brush size bigger. I'll pick 9%. And first I will darken the branches here, so they get darker from the foliage. I will also darken these, then lower the brush size to 4% and draw on the left side of the trunk. Let me actually set the eraser to this acrylic brush. And I'll erase the part here. I just think I added this shadow too much. Now this is fine. The tree is ready. And I want to add some apples on it. For that, I will create a layer above this bean shape and pick red. In the brushes, I will select noise brush. The size is set to 42% and I will draw a circle shape that is grainy. Then I will select this dark color and draw on the left lower side to darken it. After that, I will select this light color and draw here. After that, I will go to adjustments. Select perspective blur, layer, and I will position this in the middle of our shape. Then I will slide to the right till the end. So it's almost the same technique that we used for the cute cheek, but it is a little simplified. We got this shape. And to make it less transparent, I will duplicate it. Then merge. Let me scale this shape. And I will place it on the tree. Alright. Now let's try to change its blending mode. I will select linear light and lower the opacity to 67%. I think it is a little dark, so I will also go to adjustments and in hue saturation brightness, I will make it a little brighter. So I increase the brightness to 54%. After we did that, we can duplicate this shape a few times. I'll place this one here, then duplicate it again. Drag this one a bit down. So this way these shapes match with the tree color somehow. We can see this greenish coming through the shape. And it looks more natural this way. I will place one apple here on a smaller shape. And this is enough for now. Let's merge these four layers for now. I will also merge the layers for the tree trunk and its shadow. And actually, I will merge all the layers for the tree. At this stage, we can actually try to apply the first texture. So I'll create a layer above the tree, clip it, and I will select the darkest green color from the palette. In the brush set, I will pick this mixed paper brush. With the maximum size, I will draw all over the tree. As you can see, it got too dark. So what we can do is first change the layer's blending mode. Let's see what will work best. I think soft light is fine. Now it looks like wool, even not like paper. And I like this result. We can definitely merge the tree and this texture. I'll duplicate this layer. And I will move one of them to the right. Flip horizontal. Scale. And make it match with the circle on the edge. But I also don't want it to go outside my canvas, so I will scale it as much as needed. Scale and also rotate. Now it matches. Let's add more greens. So I will create a layer above all layers. And I think actually before doing that, we can apply texture on the grass. So since we already created a layer, I will just clip it. And we have this dark green color selected. So I will also use it. In the brushes, I will select fabric texture. The opacity of this brush is set to 67%. And the size is at around 40. I will draw on the left side. Not pressing on the pencil too much. The Then I will switch to the lightest green and draw on the right side. If you want to darken or lighten some part more, you can simply move this texture. I like it this way. Now we can merge these two and create one more layer. I will pick this base green color and acrylic brush. I will draw an oval shape under the tree. This way. Paint inside it. Let me actually move it a bit to the left. I'll paint it more. And I will draw a smaller one somewhere here. So these are like two soft shapes. And to add texture, we can either alpha lock the layer or create another layer with a clipping mask. I think I will also use the second option because I may want to move it or adjust somehow. So I will clip this layer. First, pick the darkest green. And this time I will be using cloudy splash brush. With the brush size set to 20%, I will draw on the lower part of each shape. Actually, the brush size can be even smaller, like 14. So I will draw on the lower part of a bigger shape first, and then on the smaller one. Also on the left side of it. Then I will select the lightest green and draw on this edge. And on a bigger shape. Let me switch to this dark green again to mix the colors a bit so there is no this sharp border between the colors. I'm making these sketchy strokes. This is fine. I just want to merge these two layers. And I'll use Liquify to scale this big bush. Alright. After that, I will duplicate this layer and drag it to the front. I'll scale it because it is closer to the viewer, so the shapes can be bigger. And I will rotate it a little. All right. If it looks a little transparent, we can duplicate this layer. Let me merge these two and I'll fix this edge with the eraser set to acrylic brush. Now that's much better. Let's add a few apples on the ground. So I will go to the layer with the apples, then to selection and outline one of them in freehand mode. Then I will click copy and paste in this menu. When I click on the arrow, I can drag it. But we need to move it above the grass. We can see that the layers mode has changed to normal. So I will go and select linear light again, also lowering the opacity. It was 67%. Since the background color under this shape is a bit too dark, I will lighten it even more. I increased the brightness to 57%. I'll duplicate this one, scale it, just making it slightly smaller. Then duplicating again the small one, and I'll place it here. We can actually merge these three layers too, and I'll drag them on top of all layers to move them a little up. Before we proceed to the main character of our illustration, we can also add textures on the background layer. For that, I'll create a layer above this blue circle, clip it, and pick white color from the background using my finger. In the brushes, I will select Cloudy Splash. Let's make the size 28%, and I will draw on the lower edge. Add in the texture. After that, I will create a new layer. Go to selection. Pick freehand. And here I will create a cloud shape that will have a few curves on top. One, two, then another one, and then it will go this way. I'll tap here, so we got the selection, and with this white color and the current brush, I will make a few strokes on top. Maybe we can even lower the size to 20%. I'll make a few more strokes to create this shape. After we deselect, we can go to adjustments and apply Gaussian blur on this layer to soften the edges of the cloud. 3% will be enough. We can also use transformation to rotate it and move to place it wherever we want. I'm quite satisfied with this. What we have left is to add this paper texture that we have on the tree. Before merging the layers, I want to fix the edge of this blue circle, because it doesn't match with the entire composition, where we have this wet edge and here it is sharp. So I will go to the layer with the circle, grab this blue color that it has, and in the brushes I will select acrylic brush. I will make it full opacity, and the size can be set to 5%. I will just go around the edge and make these strokes to make it look wet. This arc. I'm lifting the pencil from the canvas while doing it, so the strokes are more intense. Here we can't see it. Alright, now that's better. It doesn't have to be perfect. What we have left is to add this paper texture. So we can merge these three layers, create a layer above, and I will go to the disk to select pure black color by double tapping. In the brushes I will pick our paper texture. Let's not forget to clip the layer to the circle and then paint all over it. After we change the layer's blending mode to overlay, we can check what we got. To me it looks a bit too dark, so I will also change the layer's opacity to 70%. Now it's great. We can see the structure of the paper, but it's not too dark. Now that the background is ready, we can finally proceed to drawing our main character. So we can now merge all the layers, and I'll create a layer above it. Let me select this brown color from the palette, and I will be using 6B pencil to create a quick sketch. Actually, I will keep only the new layer visible, so I can draw it, and then we will place it according to the composition. Let's begin with the basic shapes. So I will draw sort of an oval first. Alright, now let's draw a smaller oval for the head here. Then I will draw the ears. Here we will draw the leg that is closer to us. So I will continue this oval. And make it this way for now. Here I will draw another leg. Let's draw something like this for the front limb. And I will sketch the tail. Also an oval. Now I will adjust these shapes to make it look more like a rabbit. I will actually change the color into black. Make this curve for the back. Here it will be like a curve too. Then it will go to the chest. And in this shape, I will cut an arc on top and also at the bottom. Then I will make it like this. Let me actually erase it here. So on the head, I will make it more narrow here. And also at the bottom, I'll make it more curvy. This will look more like a rabbit head. All right. The ears are totally fine. I will just make this inner part. And then another ear. Well, on this leg, I will also cut a curve here. And here. Maybe on the lower part it can also be more curvy. And here as well. On the tail, I'll make it two curves instead of one. Something like heart shape. And we can actually add the second limb that we can see. All right, let's draw the nose here on the edge. I will just darken a triangle. Then I will draw the eye somewhere in the middle. And it will have two curves, one on top and another one at the bottom. I will keep the white gap for the light reflection and paint the area inside the eye. Let's try to make it a little bigger maybe, so he looks more cute. And later when we use the paintbrush, we can make this white spot bigger as well. let's make this arc. And I think our hair looks cute. Now that we have the sketch, I will create a layer above it. Or actually, we can place the new layer underneath and set the sketch to multiply. But I will lower its opacity to 30%. First, I will select the color from this row that comes first. These are all colors that we'll be using to draw the hair. I'll select acrylic mixed brush. Set the brush size to 10% and draw inside the sketch. I will lower the size to paint in smaller shapes. Paint in this leg. Then this one. Actually, I love painting animals very much. It's like my favorite topic. I hope you enjoy it too. In the head, we can increase the size. I'm just blocking the color. And I'll also draw in the ears. All right. I'll remove the sketch. And actually, I will duplicate this layer to make the color more opaque. Then I will merge these two layers. And I think I will clean it up here with the eraser set to acrylic brush. Also this back. We just couldn't see it below the sketch. Also here. Okay, now let me bring back the sketch and we can apply more colors and shadows. So let's select the next color from the palette and I will apply it on the ears. We can actually alpha lock the layer so the strokes don't go outside it. I'm painting inside this ear, also on the head, and here. We can add this color here on the front part of his face. And also on the body. and a bit on the tail. Now I will select the next color. And here I will lower the opacity down to 95%. The brush size will be set to 4%. Or maybe even less. Let's try 3%. I will draw on this line that we defined on the ear to darken it. I'm not pressing too much. Then I'll increase the brush size a little and draw at the bottom part of the second ear. I'll also draw slightly on this part of the head. Lower the size, and maybe we can decrease the opacity even to 80%. I'll draw here. And then blend it. Alright, let's add this dark color on top of this leg or arm, or actually it is a paw. I will darken it here. And create a shadow on the neck, under the head. Make a few bigger strokes to the left. I will also draw on the tail. On the left side of it. And on this paw. Now I will pick white. First I will draw around the eye. With 100% opacity and the brush size set to 3%. Just lightening this area. Let's also paint on the tail here and on the belly. I will paint it here on the chest. Finally, I will select black. Lower the brush size to 1%. And draw the nose. And also the eye. Following this sketch. But I will try to keep a bigger gap for the light reflection. Let's try to remove the sketch and see what we got. I think it turned out quite nice. I will only add more of this peach color on the paw. and then I will switch to the base color and paint here to blend the colors together. I just think it got a little too dark. Now that's fine. Let's delete the sketch. I will rotate the hare and move him, creating the same angle that our ground has. I want him to look like he's jumping downwards. Alright, this is fine. Let me create a layer above the hare and clip it. I will select this brown. And in the brushes, I will pick fabric texture. I'll make it full opacity and paint all over the hare shape. The size is set to 27% here. We also need to change the blending mode of this layer. So we keep the texture and adjust the colors at the same time. Here I will select color burn. But if it got too dark, we can lower the layer's opacity. I will keep it 67%, but you can totally go according to your result. And now our illustration is ready.
If you enjoyed this tutorial, please give it a like and subscribe to my channel. If you share your drawing on Instagram, tag me in your post so I'll be able to see it. You can support me and unlock even more tutorials on my Patreon page. You'll find a link to it in the description to this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.